क्वेश्चन फॉर सैलरी और कमीशन टू द पार्टनर्स, रेडी? सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 31, अमर भानु एंड चारू आर पार्टनर्स इन अ फर्म, ओके? अमर एंड भानु आर टू गेट एनुअल सैलरी ऑफ 120,000 पर एनम ईच एज दे मैनेज द बिजनेस. नेट प्रॉफिट फॉर द ईयर इज 4,80,000 रुपीज. डिटरमाइन द शेयर ऑफ प्रॉफिट टू बी क्रेडिटेड टू ईच पार्टनर. इट इज वेरी वेरी सिंपल. इट इज नॉट मेंशन टू प्रिपेयर P&L अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट, बट यू कैन, इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर व्हेन यू सॉल्विंग, व्हेन यू आर सॉल्विंग ना एंड यू आर गोइंग टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट प्रॉफिट टू द पार्टनर, इट इज ऑलवेज बेटर टू प्रिपेयर P&L अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट, इवन इन वर्किंग नोट ऑल्सो. वी कैन सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन विदाउट वर्किंग नोट ऑल्सो, देर इज नो इश्यू. ओके, सो द टोटल प्रॉफिट इज 4,80,000. आई विल प्रिपेयर प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट. रेडी? डेबिट साइड, क्रेडिट साइड बाय नेट प्रॉफिट 4,80,000 नेट प्रॉफिट. देन अकॉर्डिंग टू क्वेश्चन अमर एंड भानु आर टू गेट एनुअल सैलरी. सो टू सैलरी अमर एंड भानु, हाउ मच? 1,20,000 ईच. 1,20,000 ईच, इट मीन्स 2,40,000. 4,80,000 माइनस 2,40,000, हाउ मच इज रिमेनिंग? 2,40,000 is remaining. It will be distributed to the partners. To profit transfer to partners capital account. Amar, Bhanu, and third one is Charu. In which ratio? Tell me. 4,80,000. 4,80,000. You can see in the question, the ratio is not given. And when the ratio is not given, then which ratio it is distributed? It is distributed equally. Is that clear? 1:1:1, 3. 2,40,000 divided by 3, 80,000. So 80,000 profit will be distributed to all partners equally. So in this question, what was the point? When the profit sharing ratio is not given, it is to be considered that they are distributing equally. I hope this question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Question number 32. A, B and C are partners sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 2:2:1. A is entitled to a commission of 10% on the net profit. Net profit is 1,10,000. Determine the amount of commission payable to A. How much A is getting? A is entitled to a commission of 10% on the net profit. So it is very, very simple, dear children. 1,10,000, 10% commission payable to A. $1,10,000 is net profit and 10%, how do we calculate percent? Divide by 100. It will be 11,000. So commission payable to A in this question is 11,000. Any doubt? I hope there is no doubt in this question. Hona bhi nahi chahiye. Hai na? So let's move on next question. Question number 33. Yes, some more good question. Question number 33. X, Y and Z are partners sharing profit and losses equally. X, Y, Z are partners sharing profit and losses equally. As per the partnership deed, Z is entitled to a commission of 10%. on the net profit after charging such commission. The net profit before charging such commission is 2,20,000. Determine the amount of commission payable to Z. Dear children, it is mentioned that Z is entitled to a commission of 10% of the net profit after charging such commission. So when we need to calculate Z's commission on net profit and profit before charging is given, how to calculate? The rate of interest is rate of commission is given 10% and it is after charging. So what we do, we add rate in 100 also, 100 plus 10, then we calculate after charging 10 upon 110. So let's calculate 2,20,000 multiply by 10 upon 110. So 20,000 commission will come. So when after charging what is given, always add rate with the 100. If it is 12%, then 12 by 112. If it is 15%, then 15 by 115. If it is after charging, if after charging word is given and before charging profit is given. Okay. I hope it is very clear to everyone. These are very simple and small concepts. Question number 34. Next question. One more very good question. A, B, C, D are partners in a firm sharing profits in the ratio of 4-3-2-1. A, B, C, D distributing profit and losses in the ratio of 4-3-2-1. It earned net profit of rupees 1,80,000 for the year ended 2020. So profit earned is 1,80,000 during year. Fine. As per the partnership deed, they are to charge a commission at the rate of 20% of the profit after charging. Is that clear, dear children? After charging what is given? After charging such commission, which they will share as 2-3-2-3. So whatever commission will come now, that commission they will distribute in the ratio of 2-3-2-3. This is what the condition in this question. You are required to show appropriation of profit among the partners. So we can prepare profit and loss appropriation account. First we will calculate commission. Commission is 20% of the profit after charging such commission. Okay, dear children. So let's calculate commission first. Amount of commission. Rate is given 20%, but it is mentioned after charging. So what we do? We add rate with the 100, so 20 upon 120. So 1,80,000 into 20 divided by 120, 30,000 commission, which will be distributed by the partner in the ratio 2:3:2:3, in this ratio. Is that clear? So let's prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Profit and loss appropriation account. Okay, debit side, credit side. By net profit, how much net profit was available in the question? 1,80,000 to commission to the partners. The name of partners are A, B, C, D. What was the commission? We have computed 30,000. So this 30,000 is distributed to the partners in which ratio? 2-3-2-3. When we add, we get 10. 30,000 divided by 10, 3,000, 3 2 jar. 6000 9000 6000 and 9000, is that clear? And then whatever left, that is profit, to profit distributed or transferred to partner's capital account. Partner's capital account A, B, C, D. So how much profit will be remaining? 1,80,000 minus 30. 1,50,000 profit is remaining. This 1,50,000 will be distributed in which ratio? This 1,50,000 will be distributed in the ratio of 4:3:2:1. So 4:3:2:1 means 10. So 1,50,000 divided by 10, 15,000, 15 4 ja, 60,000, 15 3 ja, 45,000, 15 2 ja, 30,000 and 15 1 ja, 15,000. Is that clear, dear children? So I hope this question is clear. Very simple question, very basic. All these questions are very general. One more very good question, question number 35. X and Y are partners in a firm. Okay, X and Y are partners in a firm. X is entitled to a salary of 10,000 per month. X is entitled to 10,000 salary per month and commission of 10% of the net profit after partner salaries but before charging commission. So 10% commission of the net profit, 10% commission after partner salary. First salary is given and then 10% commission will be given, but before charging commission. Okay. Y is entitled to a salary of 25,000 per annum. Y will get salary 25,000 per annum and commission of 10% of the net profit after charging all commission and partner salaries. So he will also get 10% commission, but after charging everything, salary and commission of these two also, charging all commission and partner salaries, net profit before providing for partner salary and commission for the year was 4,20,000. So distribution of profit, the profit was given 4,20,000. We need to show distribution of profit and we better distribute in profit and loss appropriation account. So let's prepare profit and loss appropriation account. Okay. Let's start. Debit side, credit side, by net profit. Net profit is 4,20,000. So first we give salary to the partners, two salaries. What is the salary of X? 10,000 salary per month. So means 1,20,000 salary X will get and Y will get 25,000 per annum. So 25,000 per annum Y will get. So 1,20,000 plus 25, 1,45,000 salary we have given. Then X will get 10,000 per 10% commission after partner salary, isn't it? In the question, it is clearly mentioned commission of 10% of the net profit after partner salaries. Okay, so we need to calculate the commission of X. Small working note, commission of X, working note. So the total profit which was available, that was 4,20,000. After salaries means 1,45,000. 1,45,000 is the salary of the partners. So 4,20,000 minus 1,45,000 is equal to 2,75,000. So he will get commission of 2,75,000, 10%. 10% means 10/100 means 27,500 is the commission of X. So 2 commission according to question. The commission of X is 27,500 because in the question it is mentioned after partner salaries. So partner salaries is 1,45,000. So out of profit when partner salaries are deducted, 2,75,000 is remaining, and we will calculate 10% of 2,75,000, that is 27,500. This is commission of X. Now we need to calculate commission of Y also. So let's calculate commission of Y. According to question, Y will get commission after partner salaries and all commission. So after partner salaries, 2,75,000 is remaining after partner salaries and all commissions means 27,500. This commission will also to be subtracted. So 2,75,000 minus 27,500. So it will be 2,47,500, and it is mentioned that after charging his commission also, when we need to calculate commission after charging, how do we calculate? 10 upon 100 plus rate means 110, isn't it? So 2,47,000 into 10 divided by 110, 22,500. This is the commission of Y. I hope you have clearly understood how your sir has computed this, where these values, So the commission of Y is 22,500. So it will be 50,000, isn't it? So let's compute 4,20,000. Let's see how much we will distribute. 4,20,000 minus 1,95,000. So 2,25,000 is remaining in the debit side. So this is the profit. So this profit is to be distributed to the partners. So to profit transfer to partners capital account. The name of partners are X and Y. So this 2,25,000 will be distributed. But ratio, let's see, in this question ratio is not given, and when ratio is not given, what we do, dear children? We will distribute equally. So 2,25,000 divided by 2, 1,12,500. So I hope the question is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children, question is clear.